beautiful ones, and welcome to your practice. As you find yourself on the mat, use this time to very purposefully create a transition. Maybe you've come from work, so you've navigated stoplights and stop signs and all the things to get here. Maybe you've already been at home and you've had to prepare things, move the couch out of the way, whatever it may be. And here now, you start to find yourself landing on your mat. And if you think about it, we've come from the macro, a bigger world, even if it was our house, to then just a micro, the four corners of the mat. So it's a huge transition, energetically and literally. This is an enormous transition. So that's our theme today, is transitions. And transitions, spiritually, are often one of the most challenging parts of life, as well as in that place where we find our greatest growth. So maybe befriend the transitions in our life and hold to heart that some transitions are longer and some transitions are shorter. We care deeply about the impact and what's going on and our focus and our involvement in periods of transition, but we also in yoga have a sense of surrender because there are things that we don't control. And sometimes the long ones just mean that we're in gestation, like it took you 9 months to even be born in your body, and that transition is just as long as it is, right? And other times it's just a day or an hour or a moment. But as you find yourself in a seat, know that this is profound. Just coming to the mat and transitioning from busy in the head to now dropping into your heart. As you sit tall, a couple deep breaths, and then create Vishnu Mudra. With your right hand, palm out, take the baby finger and ring finger in, and then from here, just take the baby finger and ring finger to the outside of the left side of your nose. Put a little pressure. Okay, test that out. Now take your right thumb and put a little pressure to the outside of the right side of your nose. Okay, so these two will be the ones applying pressure. Okay, now as you're ready, open the right, inhale through the right side of your nose, close off the right, open the left, and breathe all the way out the left side. Close off both, and just hold the breath out. We call this breath suspension, kabak. Open right, inhale, 1, 2, 3, 4, close off right, open left, exhale, 4, 3, 2, 1, close off both, hold the breath out. 4, 3, 2, 1. Open right, inhale, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Close off right, open left, exhale, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Close off both, hold the breath out. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Again, once more on your own. This is a variation of alternate nostril breathing. Surya Vadana, only breathing in the right, the masculine side, the solar side. One type of transition is the summer solstice. Another type of transition is the winter solstice. And then after that last one, just sit with your hands on your lap, palms down, ground you, so that you fully land and transition from all the stuff you were doing, work in the yard, work on your home computer, coming from work, to just being here. Just notice what it was like when you held the breath out, for that is that place of potential. And the mantra, I am becoming. Hands come next to us. Inhale, left arm up. And then exhale over to the right. Inhale, fold. beginning, middle, top of the breath. Exhale, beginning, middle. You arrive in pose at the end of the breath. Inhale, beginning, middle, top of the breath, palm out. Exhale, beginning, middle, end of the breath. Inhale, hands to our hearts. Exhale, twist to the right, right hand behind, left hand to your right knee. Three deep breaths. So when you connect to the breath, you'll find that it takes the whole breath before you get to the final experience of the pose. It's not inhale, race there, and then wait. Inhale, hands back to our hearts, back to center. And then exhale, start the twist, beginning, middle. And the exhale, right hand to left knee, left hand, fingertips behind you. And just be twisting to the left. Three deep breaths. So in actuality, the getting there, whatever the destination is of your journey, and the leaving where you were, those are just blips. The majority of the time, we are in transition. Inhale, leaving that place, hands to our heart, and returning to center. Finishing the exhale. Hands come behind us. Legs unravel, toes forward, fingers forward. And just stay here. This is really fruitful. Just opening the front body. Or start your breath and start lifting your hips after you initiate with your breath. And then a couple more breaths up here. Your head can look wherever it feels good. And then when your exhale next comes, take the full breath of the exhalation to come down so you never feel like you're dropping yourself. This also reduces anxiety of trying to race through the transition periods of our life. As you cross your shins and walk over them, come into all fours, quadruped. Now, inhale, exhale, elbows come down, look in the direction of your thighs, and round, sit bones down. Inhale, open your throat, look forward, lift your elbows, lengthen your shoulders, sit bones high, cow pose. Exhale, close your throat, forearms to the ground, gazing back, lifting the back of the heart like a cat. Inhale, fill the entire pose of cow, from anterior tone. Exhale, take your time, enjoy the transition to get to the pose. Once more, inhaling. So the more we resist inside the question mark, the harder it is. Stay here. Inhale, lift your right elbow up. Look right. Exhale, right elbow down, head center. Inhale, left elbow starts lifting, lifting, turning your head to look left, lifting out of the shoulder, and then exhaling down. And we'll alternate just a couple times, breathing in to this little twist, breathing out to neutral. And you'll start to notice that breath to breath, there's a pause at the end of the exhalation. Honor that pause, that transition point, for that's where change happens. Now stay here to the right and thread your left arm all the way under, left cheek and shoulder to the ground. If you have a brick, you could put your head on a brick instead. So at the end of the exhale, there's that pause, a sacred pause, and that's where change is occurring. Stay here, or lift your right leg into the air, any amount. But any change you make, everything changes.
Inhale back to our hands, gazing out through an open sit bones high. Exhaling to this little cat back. Inhale, left elbow lifts. And then stay here. Exhale, right arm threads under, right cheek and shoulder to the ground. Looking up over your left shoulder. And so happiness is constantly in a state of becoming as well. So if we're in one moment of happiness and we don't want it to end, then there's resistance to the transition to the next moment, and that's when we suffer. Stay here, left toes to the back of the mat. This is already a balance challenge. Or lift your leg into the air and make a bigger balance challenge. Left knee lowers. Take the whole breath so there's no urgency. Inhale, back to your hands. Curl your toes. Exhale, lift your knees just a little bit. Inhale, lift your hips a lot, lift your heels, make the tallest triangle possible. Exhale, heels towards the ground. Inhale, shift forward, high push-up position. Put your knees down or not. Exhale, slowly to lower to your belly. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Point your toes, inhale your cobra, beginning, middle, top of the breath. Curl your toes, exhale, lift your hips. Now, inhale, lift your knees, lift your hips higher, heels higher. Exhale, heels to the ground. Left foot closer to the right. Inhale, right leg lifts, beginning. Middle, top of the breath. Exhale, knee between your elbows, beginning. Look forward, step forward, middle. Exhale, end of the breath, back heel down. Hover your fingers, feel the pause. Inhale, circle your arms, out and up, warrior one. Exhale, hands come behind us, uniting. Now inhale, lift the front body, knuckles slide down the back, lift, lift, lift. So peak of your heart at the end of the inhale, and then exhale, hands to the ground. Step back, plank. Take a breath, exhale, lower down slow. Enjoy the ride down. Inhale, beginning, middle, unfurl, top, toes under, exhale, lead with your sit bones, inhale, knees, sit bones higher, heels higher, belly in, exhale, heels down, right foot next to left, inhale, take the full length of the breath to lift your left leg, exhale, tiger curl, beginning of the exhale, foot lands, middle of the exhale. Right heel flat, toes to 1 o'clock, warrior one legs. Pause, lift your fingers. Now inhale, circle the arms out and up. Exhale, whole breath to unite your hands behind you. Breathe in and explore the beautiful back bend. And then exhale. Hands to the ground. Beginning of the exhale, back heel lifts. Step back. End of the exhale, take a breath. Exhale. Flow halfway down to Chaturanga or to your belly. Inhaling your back. And exhaling. Downward facing dog. Nice and easy. Left foot to right. Vyadam. Inhale, right leg up, peak of the breath. Then exhale. This is the transition. Foot forward, back heel flat. Hold the breath out, hover. Inhale, open your arms all the way up. Only at the top is the peak of the breath. You arrive. skip these, and meet us in downward facing dog without the basic connecting vinyasa. Right foot to left. Inhale, left leg up to the sun. Exhale, there's time to set your foundation in warrior one legs. And then suspend the breath. Inhale, without that urgency, all the way up. Exhale, find yourself holding hands behind you. Inhale, this then moves into the transition of this next pose. Exhale, this is where we add on, bowing humbly, warrior four. Inhale, come up, reach up, peak of inhale. Exhale, hands have time to come down. You have time to transition to plank. Breathing in, exhale, lowering down. Inhaling, peak, exhale. It takes the whole exhalation, and then only at the last moment we metamorphosize into down dog. Inhale, right leg rises all the way up. Exhale. Then as we come through, this is the transition, warrior one legs. And then it's a moment to be there. Inhale, reaching up, we add on. Exhale, yoga mudra. Breathe all the way in and up. Exhale, we fold forward. Inhaling, come on up. Now exhale, right arm forward, down and back to your back leg, look right, or put the hand behind your low back. Take a breath. Exhale, hands to the ground. Step back, breathe in, and then decide either the connecting basic vinyasa or skip that to downward facing dog. But it is your choice. So inhale, left leg. Just reaches skyward. It has its time. It's not trying to go faster. Exhale, squeeze in. Step. Plant. Pause. Inhale. Every time we recognize the transition, we allow ourselves to keep changing from caterpillar to butterfly. Breathing in, up and back. Exhale. Bowing into ourselves. Take your time. Inhale. As you lift up, let your arms come. Now exhale, left arm forward, down and back. Inhale, look left into this twist. Exhale, hands down. Inhale here and tap your right shoulder. Exhale, tap, 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 tap. Breathing in, breathing out. Tap, 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 hold. Inhale, exhale, lower. Inhale, rise. Exhale, downward facing dog. We add on. Inhale, this is a ladder flow. Exhale, ensure your ride to engage here. And then inhale, feel the air as you transition. Exhaling, exploring. Breathe in, find new space in front of your heart. Exhale, going deeper and deeper. Inhaling, coming up, reaching up. Exhale, right arm comes back. Inhale here, we add on. Exhale, left hand in front into the left, and right arm up. Stay into the exhale into your right foot. And this is revolved half moving. Revolved half moving. Inhale. Exhale, right hand lowers. Standing splits or just get strong. strong with your legs there as they are, or practice going up and down to start to feel what it would be like to take a little hop. It doesn't have to be far. And then once you're ready, meet me in plank. From here, pick your left hand up, put your forearm down. Pick your right hand up, put your forearm down. Pick your left forearm up, put your hand down. Come back to your right hand. So you got it. Down, down, up, up, down, down, up, up, hold. And downward facing dog. Deep breath in. Deep breath out. Inhale, left leg. It's just enjoying the ride, right? It loves the transition. Exhale into your warrior one legs. And then inhale, adding warrior one arms to lighten that. Exhale, reuniting your hands. Sit low. Breathe into your back foot, heart high. Exhale. Bowing deep. Inhale. So some transitions are harder, like coming up. Exhale. Left arm reaches to your back leg or behind your waist. Take a breath into this twist. Exhale. Right hand in front, back to your lips. Inhale. Right leg lifts. Twist left. Exhale. Left arm up. Deep breaths, revolved half moon B. Now, if you try to grip, it's going to make it harder. If you allow for little micro movements, much easier. Left hand down, and you can add handstand hops here again, or just notice what it's like to just, okay, I tap, I lift, I tap, I lift. Yeah? It doesn't have to be kick up. It could be, but it doesn't have to be. Back to plank. Pick your right hand up, forearm down. Left forearm, right, left hand. Right forearm, right, left. Forearm, see? So this is like life. Sometimes the transitions are harder than you wish. Inhale, exhale, knees down, heart high. And then some transitions, we're like, oh, stinks, I love this one. Lift your elbows if you wish. So this is where the sutras are clear, chapter 2, verse 7, chapter 2, verse 8, that longing for the pleasures, like, oh, I like this one, our preferences, and then aversion towards those things that we don't like. Like, oh, I don't like this transition. That one was hard. But when we're pulling and pushing in a tug of war, then we suffer. Elbows down, open them apart, and just rest your head. Big breath in, and then exhale. Three deep breaths. And just notice that your ability to just be in the question mark gets easier and easier. Less resistance. And naturally, like effervescent little bubbles, the answers from within start to reveal themselves. While at the same time, we know there's things outside ourselves we can't control, like how long we'll be in the transition in our life. 9 months? 9 days? 9 minutes? Bring your hands under your elbows. Inhale, cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, right leg lifts, 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 lifts. And then exhale, bring your right knee towards your left elbow. and stretch it out like the letter L. Now we're going to stay here. I am becoming. But this pose could become, if you want, left heel flat, left arm up, Parshavasana 2. And if it did, then left hand down, heel up, right hip down, and you could stay upright, back toes under, internal rotation, or come into your forearms, or come all the way down to your belly, fallen warrior. But we're creating a neural pathway because this position of our legs is exactly what we're going to do in a different space. And can you take some of the feeling, the vibration, the ease that you have here into a more challenging transition place? Walk back in. Pick your bottom hip up and step back, downward dog. Inhale, walk backwards. Stay for the exhale. Inhale, arms open out and up. Exhale, hands to our heart, double weight your left foot. Inhale, lift your right leg. Exhale, twist right. Both hands can go outside your right thigh, or right arm could reach back. If you want, left hand can come outside your right foot. Your leg can stretch long, just like we did moments ago. Either way, you're in a twist. Come back. Knee forward, hands to our waist, inhale, exhale, let your right foot step out, inhale, gather your hands to your heart, exhale, soft step down, gather yourself, and then fall gracefully, gather, and then allow the transition to be a little messy, but know that you can catch yourself. Center. For sometimes we so get afraid of transitions, of making a choice, this or that, that or this, we just stay in the razor's edge. So how long could you stay here? 9 minutes, 9 hours, 9 days, 9 months? Right foot lowered. Release. Inhale, circle up. Exhale, fold down the midline. Inhale. Walk your hands downward facing dog. Stay for the exhale. Inhale, left leg rises, beginning, middle, it's in the transition. Only now does it get to the actual pose. Exhale, hug your knee in, shift forward, knee to your right, and stretch your leg out like a letter L. I am becoming. Caterpillar to butterfly. Everyone's at their own stage. This is maybe where you're at, or right heel flat, and perhaps you're starting to press one wing out. Right hand down, back heel up, take a breath. Slower than you want to. Exhale down to your left toe, and look left. Sometimes there's some sweet sensation, this little twist. And some people feel more upright, or come down to your forearms, or come all the way down. You're deciding. But try not to expand too far too fast. You don't have to push the transitions to go any faster. There's something that knows what it's doing. Just try to be with the growth. So this is going to be the same. As we walk back in from fallen warrior, back to its under, your bottom hip up, and transition downward facing dog. between your wings, or right hand outside your left foot, left arm back. So try to breathe in a way that allows, however long you're going to be here, to just have an experience, no expectation, just allow. Bend your leg, hands back to your waist. Inhale, exhale, step off lightly into your left foot. And then hands gather to your heart. Inhale, find your center. And then exhale, soft knees. Breathing in. Breathing out. I'm not afraid of the falling, so notice how graceful we can transition to the fall. Right? It's not just, I'm here, I got here, but whatever it is, hold, exhale, lift, foot down, inhale, circle up, exhale, bow in, inhale, walking all the way to plank, breathing in, breathing out. The ball, or if you wish, right arm can go to the right, left arm to the left. Or if you have a pillow, this is really great to do with a little pillow. I'll use bricks, they work too. Just to support it down, facing twist. This twist first, just see right and feeling that outer right hip. So what does it continue to change and evolve? And walk yourself in and up, look down, and shift to your shins. And then exhale, bring your knees to the right. Come down on your left hip. And again, you could use something or nothing at all. And just make it a downward facing twist. Left arm out. Left ear down. Knees could be quite snug, further apart. Or on a bolster, on a pillow. Make yourself comfortable. But it's in these moments we realize that the poses are not the questions, the poses are the answers. But it's only after we're out. So walk back in. Slide your left arm under. Come onto your back. Pause for a moment, for this has been a really huge transition from front to back. Just try to just be. Just do nothing but stay grounded. So emotionally, you don't have to over-regulate. No trigger, fear response, fight or flight. Transition, I stay with my breath, who's big, who's facing down, I'm facing up. If I just stay calm. And I stay grounded in the transition points. notice how you're feeling, if you're ready for this transition of your vulnerable parts facing up. This is very soul, front bodies, futures, the sun's up. But equally, if you get here, you're like, stay the transition just a little bit longer. Then you could always roll to your belly, activating more of the parasympathetic nervous system. Downward facing shavasana. So as you start to co-create with the universe, not only can you not can you unlearn your fear of transitions, you could actually start to be inspired by them. Say, okay, I need a little bit more lunar time before I go into that sun side, just a little bit more quiet. Stay as long as you wish.
And just remember that we're always in some sort of transition. May not have how long they last. Some of them are more difficult, some of them are less so. Some of them take much longer. Some of them are quite short. May you allow them to be in the place where you find change. Place of what's not but yet made manifest. The sutras teach us that who you are now is not yet who you're meant to be. You are becoming. Wherever you are in that state of becoming, I honor you deeply. Stay graceful, feel into your vulnerability, and allow your heart to be as courageous as it is. To seal this practice from my heart to yours, may you love yourself, love your day, and love your life. Muchísimas gracias. And thank you, infinite thank yous. My name is Sylvia Mordini, the founder of Life Inspired and Alchemy of Yoga. It's been a joy to be with you today in transition, and take the time you need to transition from your practice.